ligaw man at mawala. Umikot man sa kawalan, sa bawat kailan, sino at saan, ikaw lamang ang kasagutan. Sa bawat kanan at kaliwa, kung timog man o hilaga, ang bawat daan ko ay patungo, ay pabalik sa iyo. Forgive me for quoting myself, it will make more sense later. I'm here to talk about music, how it found me, shaped me, many points in my life, saved me, ultimately led me home. But in order for me to tell you where I am now and where I want to go, I think it's also important for you guys to know kung saan ako galing. Ako po yung nabubuhay sa paniniwalang walang bagay na galing sa wala. Lahat tayo yung pinanggalingan, pinaroroonan, at patutunguhan. At ang akin pong pinanggalingan ay isang napakalaking pamilya. Huge. Okay. I have 3 older brothers, 2 younger sisters, 1 mom, 1 dad, both older than me, handful of dogs along the way. I live in the shadows every day. They are some of the most talented people I've ever met. I'm proud of them every day. My eldest brother, Dennis, is a doctor. A few years ago, he had a phone with a decent camera and started taking shots of random objects like ants, stones, and leaves, posted them on Facebook. Gusto ng mga tao. So eventually, someone in the family gave him a camera. And now he takes concert and wedding photography for a living. And he still has time to be a doctor. My other brother, Vin, who was in UP Diliman last week, is a lawyer by profession, but he's also a musician. He writes his own songs, plays for his own band, Periodico. He is the head of his own startup company called Jumajam, which focuses on alternative ways of education, perhaps through music. And he's also my lawyer. My third brother, Marvin, is pretty much a straight arrow. Breezed through school. Talinong tao. Meron siyang MBA. He has a really good job. 3 wonderful kids. Works even during weekends so that his kids will have a good life. The youngest in the family is Mia. I saw her struggles when she was a child, and she overcame everything. She is a really good architect. So good, in fact, that she designed the home where my parents live in now. I'm especially proud of my other sister, May, who is a dentist. Number 6 siya sa board niya. But she also, eto, maraming sombrero tong kapatid kong to. She paints, she makes pots, she's part of a choir, she takes photos also, and then recently she took a break from dentistry to go to culinary school. Came home with a gold medal 2 weeks ago, and if I'm not mistaken, she's in the running for valedictorian. So, yeah, multi-potentialites. Which leads to me. I'm hardly a potentialite, I think. Growing up, I had a hard time communicating with people, making eye contact. Perhaps dahil my dad, being a banker, was assigned to different branches every year, every other year. So it was always a new home, always a new village, new neighbors, new dogs, same parents. Kaya nahihirapan akong makipag-usap sa tao. And then, the kids naman my age didn't want to talk to me because I was always the new guy. And they said I was a little strange. Ako raw yung nakaupo sa gilid, nakadungaw sa kawalan. Wala namang tinitignan. And I honestly was okay with it. Because being left alone meant having the freedom to discover my own world, make my own world. At dahil wala ko masyadong kausap, what I did was observe people who'd pass by, whole families, beggars, farmers, couples. Early on, bata pa lang ako, mahilig na ako sa pag-ibig. I would observe couples and make stories in my head, depending on the girl's maybe facial expression or the way the guy would hold their hand, touch her face. Other than that, while my siblings were busy building dreams, I was just excited for the weekend. More time for being alone. Until I found music, or more accurately, music found me. One day, my brother brought home a guitar he borrowed from our neighbor. I remember seeing it for the first time, sitting in front of my brother. Ayoko umalis, nakaganan ako for hours and hours and hours. What I would do was, whenever he leave for school, pumapasok ako sa kwarto. And I started to learn my favorite songs, but I couldn't get the chords right. Lagi nila sinasabihin, your chords are wrong. But you see, early on, I learned to listen to music not with my ears, but with my heart. It gave me a better insight on what the songwriter was trying to say, the marriage of melody and lyrics. So in college, I formed my own band. Kasi sabi ko, parang ito yung daan. So go straight, form a band. But it wasn't enough that I had my own band. I needed my own songs. I already had stories in my head. I just needed the right melodies. Nakahanap naman ako. Awan ng Diyos. I think secretly, my friends were laughing at me because at that point in school, you know, people were training to be doctors and lawyers, and I was daydreaming. My father told me before I graduated, he sat me down and said, "Anak, there's no money in music. I love you, but you need a job." I said, "Okay." So during my college band's final show, I opened for this group called Session Road. And then they saw me play, liked the songs, sat down with me and said, "So what do you want to do?" "I don't know, I mean, I need money though." So I guess I need to find a job. But I wasn't very convinced. I wasn't very convincing. So they said, "Or we can form a band and you can play your sappy love songs with us." And I said immediately, "Or we could do that." So we rehearsed, and then we called the band Sugarfree. It wasn't enough that we had our own songs. We needed something we could listen to every day because we were our own biggest fans, okay? So with my lifetime savings, we recorded the demo, shopped it around. Naturally, every label was scared of us. Very hesitant because back then, ang uso covers or songs in English, and along comes this guy who's not even good looking who insists on writing songs in Filipino. Hindi ako nagpatina. Sabi nila, "Do you have songs in English?" "No." "I'm fine where I am, thank you." Eventually, a label trusted me enough, signed us, and the rest is history. We started selling a decent amount of records. We started having bigger shows. And I went to places I couldn't even pronounce. Places I didn't even know existed. But I was also constantly surrounded by people. Surrounded by businessmen. And at some point, I think I lost my way. Sabi ko, "I'm not doing this for music anymore." It's very sad. I quit the band. And I promised myself never to step on stage again. Unfortunately, I already signed a contract with another label, so they gave me 2 months to rest. Mabait naman sila. After 2 months, they wanted me to go to the studio to write and record 20 songs, which I did. I don't know how, but my heart was not into it. They could tell. People could tell. I think I was lashing out. I was very jaded about the industry. And I just wanted to make music for myself. Until few years ago, a couple of crazy kids came up to me and said, "Sir, we'd like to borrow 20 of your songs from Sugarfree and make a musical out of it." I said, "You're crazy, but okay." So after a week, they called me and said, "Sir, we found a way to squeeze in all 20 of your songs. But can you please write another song?" I was so exasperated. I said, "Go away, I'll write your song." They wanted something to tie everything together. And at that point, I was lost. So I thought about it, I went home, and I wrote a song called Bawat Daan, which I will explain later. But perhaps the life-changing event sa buhay ko came a few months later. I was playing a show, a big show, I think it was at the Mall of Asia. I was playing in front of doctors and teachers and lawyers, big shots. After the show, someone came up to me and said, "I'm a doctor." I said, "Okay, good for you." He said, "My point being, I don't watch shows, but I enjoyed your set. Congratulations, you are a lucky guy." I said, "Sir, I think you are the lucky guy because you earn more than I do." And he said, "No, do you realize how many people you make happy?" I was taken aback. I never thought about it. Madamot akong tao eh. Gumagawa lang naman ako ng kanta para sa sarili ko. Lahat na nangyayari, bonus na lang. He said, "What you do on stage seems very natural. Like you were born to do this. So I say, you're the luckier guy because you get to do what you want. I know some doctors who are in their 40s, very successful, but they don't know what to do with their lives." He shook my hand. I went home and I cried because I didn't realize how selfish I was for not considering the people around me. And I started paying closer attention to the people who went to my shows. Usually, hindi ko pinapansin yung mga natutulog lang ako sa likod. That's a fact. I actually do fall asleep during shows. And some of them, I notice, come to my shows and then they cry. I ask them, "Why do you cry?" Some of them say, "I cry because I feel like I'm not alone. I found a friend in your songs. That means the world to me." Some people said, "I cry because your pain is almost visible. Something we can touch. Something we would like to hug." And this is the first time I'm admitting this in public. I was very ashamed until a few months ago. Last January, I was diagnosed with clinical depression. Every day is a struggle. That's why I said no to this talk last time. Because I was lost. But buti na lang nandito yung music. No matter how bad my days are, when I step on stage, I'm home, I'm free, I'm safe. I get to do what I love. And now, I realize that I have the ability to help people. I want to tell you a story about Gary Valenciano. A few years ago, we were all in Dumaguete, and then he was on stage right here. He says, "You know, people ask me." People ask me, "Will there ever be another Gary V?" And then his answer was, "No. There will never be another Gary V, or another Ebe Dancel, or another Gerald Tarot. There will never be another Gary V because we are specifically designed to be ourselves." Lahat tayo may kanya-kanyang daan na kailangan panggalingan at patumuhan. I'm going to play you that song later, but Ang dami ko sigurong na-skip dito sa talk na to. Nervous na nervous ako. I've never done this in my life. The biggest irony of it is I'm a musician and crowds overwhelm me to this very day. I'm scared of crowds. Let me leave you with a story that I always get emotional. Tell a story to my friends. I think someone at one point talked to me or wrote me a letter saying, I was about to give up on life. I was about to do something stupid. And then I listened to your song. I heard your song on the radio. You saved my life. I said, you saved mine. Thank you very much. Some of us are meant to be doctors, lawyers, politicians, even. Okay. One day, one of you will save my life in the hospital. Okay? So don't forget my face. Yeah? Someday, someone will get me out of jail. So don't forget my face. Someday, some of you will be politicians. So be honest. Lahat tayo, may kanya-kanyang daan. This is my spot. Of course, we have teachers here. Of course, we have brilliant directors who are changing the landscape of Philippine cinema. This is what I'm meant to do. Hindi man malaki yung contribution ko sa society, I try to help people one song at a time, one problem at a time. And let me tell you, it is my ultimate honor to stand before you on this stage. Home is this. Home is my mic. It's my guitar. It's the one place where I feel safe. I'd be lost. I would be absolutely lost without music. And I've found my way. And if you haven't yet, guys, you're young. It's okay. It's okay. Take your time. Be patient with yourselves. If someone like me figured it out, ano pa kaya kayo? Napakadali na siguro. Let me,
sa pagkumpas ng iyong kamay, aking landas ay ginagabay. Isang tiyak sa isang libong duda, silong sa iyak pag lumagsak. At kung puso ko ay imamapa, ikaw ang dulo, ang gitna at simula. Nahanap din kita.
Sa bawat
man sa kawalan dahil sa bawat kailan. Sino't saan, ikaw lamang ang tanging kasagutan. Bawat galan at kaliwa, at kung di mo man o kilaga ang bawat tangko ay patungo, laging pabalik sa'yo.
And that is how we say my life.